The recent audio, which has been trending, which claims that the Minister of Transportation, Rotimi Amaechi, criticized President Muhammadu Buhari and the APC, saying a lot of Nigerians are suffering, has generated a lot of controversies.
Of Buhari, everybody is crying. Pressmen are crying, farmers are crying, workers are crying, politicians are crying, students are crying. 3 years. Rate of poverty is very high. People are hungry. Nigeria will be vaccinated. President is not listening to anybody. He doesn't care. He can write it to you, right? President doesn't care. But see, he will read, he will laugh. He said, come on, see, they're abusing me here. In fact, there was one case of somebody in Odisha, a trader, who couldn't sell his goods, you understand? And I was with the guy in the plane. And the man was busy abusing Buhari, because of Buhari, the Chinese. He said, come on, I mean, what's my business with Odisha, goat seller? This country is going nowhere. Even if you divide the country to 10, it will see no change. No, I'm not joking. When Magnus was my SSG, I told him, this country is hopeless, hopeless, and helpless.
Today, Voicetv has one of the journalists who was at the meeting. Let us hear his take. Is it true that the audio was doctored?
Yes, the audio was doctored because we were at that meeting. I think I was the person that even asked the question. And the question I asked the minister then was that, considering the effort of the current administration, that does it think Nigeria can become better? And he said, and he began to give a narrative. He talked about the era of free money being gone, that those days people would just go to a government office and for political experiences they'll be given 50,000, they'll be given 100,000, and they would take that money home, give 10,000 to their wife, give another 10,000 to their drivers, use another 10, they'll just distribute the money to settle domestic issues, and those who they have given the money will also take it to the market and then spend it. So he was painting a scenario of how the money trickles down from government down to the basic of Nigerian. And he said that right now what the current government has done is that the current government has ensured that the era of free money is over, that you have to work for your money, and people do not have that any opportunity to now dip their hands into government treasuries. And he now added that look at, because of that, just 3 years, everybody is saying there is hunger in the land. The treasurers are saying there is hunger. The farmers are saying there is hunger because there is no longer free money. That President Muhammad Buhari will not condone people dipping their hands into government purse to touch free money. But if you remember that the audio which was put on the internet, that first part of the narrative was cut out. And the only part that was brought out was the part where he said there is hunger in the land, that the people are complaining, that there is no money and the rest. So it is very clear that the people who did it, they did it out of mischief because they wanted to score a certain point. I'm not a politician. I'm a journalist who happened to be at that meeting, who happened to witness the proceedings, who happened to listen to the minister speak. I'm not speaking for the minister. He has his press people to speak for him. But I think that for some of us who were at that meeting, we owe Nigerians to tell them the truth, that this was exactly the statement that was made at that meeting. So if certain people are releasing these audio clips and cutting certain parts so that certain parts of that audio will connote a different meaning, and they want to sell to Nigerians that this was what was said, then we have to absolutely stand up right now for truth, not because we want to support any political party, not because we want to support any political candidate, but because we are there. We have to come out to say this was exactly what transpired and this was exactly what happened. That is why some of us will continue to say that the audios were doctored. For those of them who have the audio, let them do Nigerians a great service by releasing the full audio clips, not just 20 seconds, not just 40 seconds, because the minister talked for over 3 minutes. Let them release the full audio clip so that Nigerians can decide if indeed he said these statements or not.
Thank you very much. I'm also here with another journalist who was at the meeting. Let's hear his position. Was the audio doctored?
I mean, it's a clear case. The audio was very, very, very doctored. If you're a media inclined person, if you're tech savvy, you would understand by merely listening to it that the audio was doctored, that there were parts that were taken out of the clips and then other parts were allowed to make it seem as if the minister was actually against his principal, which is very, very wrong. I see it as it is wrong to do. Okay, whoever did that recording was in the meeting. I was in the meeting myself, and there was no time in which the minister made that statement that said his principal did not care for Nigerians. That's a very, very incorrect statement. A reporter asked a question, about what the principal, what President Muhammad Buhari reacts to the negative interviews and write-ups that the media does about him. And the minister made it clear that the president did not care about negative comments because they were distractions. He didn't even bother to read those comments because they were distracting him from his work. That was what he meant. That was actually what he said. He did not in any way say the minister did not care about Nigerians. I mean, it is practically impossible for you to say such about your principal. No right-thinking man would say such about his principal. So the whole tape was very, very doctored. From the 40 seconds that was released to the rest, a lot of very important parts that would have explained the whole context of the interview was taken out by whoever released those videos. I mean, it's just a form of cheap blackmail, and we are not saying this because I'm not saying this because I was there that day. I'm saying it because it's the truth. I'm a journalist, and the ethics of my job makes it compulsory for me to give out truthful information at all times. So that video is very, very doctored, and it's a wrong thing to do.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome.